Tacos and tunes, YumaCon, backyard fires, intersection closure. This is City News Yuma. Keeping you updated about the city of Yuma in 3 minutes or so. Thank you for watching. With a pleasant dip in the high temperatures this past week, the time is right to start thinking again about outdoor festivals. And the date is fast approaching for this year's Tacos and Tunes, which once again this year spreads out over downtown Yuma on Saturday, October 5th. The headline entertainment this year is Cumbia Queen, a tribute to Selena, who is scheduled to take the stage at 7:30 p.m. that night. Prior to that, the band Rock of Ages will take the stage. The 200 block of Main Street will be Taco Land, where taco vendors from all over Yuma County will compete for the title of Taco King. New attractions this year include local Michelada vendors competing for the best Michelada in the desert Southwest. And if that's not your favorite drink, don't worry. There will be other tasty beverages such as margaritas by Cretines and a beer garden. Festival treats such as roasted corn, shaved ice, and other desserts will be in the 100 and 300 blocks of Main Street. Over on Madison Avenue, the Streetwise Car Club will hold its show and shine. Local dance groups will perform in both locations. Tacos and Tunes will run from 10 a.m. to 9 p.m. on October 5th. It is free to attend. Well, it turns out to be a busy weekend in Yuma, as down at the Yuma Civic Center, comics, costumes, pop culture, and gaming will once again all collide at the annual YumaCon. YumaCon provides visitors an opportunity to attend discussion panels, play tabletop games, esports, or show off their costumes. Attendees are invited to meet new friends, talk with special guests and groups, and explore the vendor gallery for fan merchandise. YumaCon will run 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. Saturday, October 5th, and 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. Sunday. Tickets are available online in advance for either single-day admission or a full weekend pass. Find info on the city website or at the Art Center, Civic Center, or Parks and Recreation offices. A recent one-week span found firefighters responding to 3 backyard fires and a vehicle fire, prompting the Yuma Fire Department to issue some reminders. First, it is illegal to burn trash or start a large bonfire in city limits without first obtaining a permit. Recreational fires should be contained in less than 3 feet by 3 feet in diameter, and those fires should not include trash or anything that could result in heavy smoke or toxic fumes. Second, fires too close to combustible materials and property lines pose serious risks of fires spreading, especially under windy conditions. Third, reduce the risk to you and your neighbors by keeping your property free of dry, dead vegetation and other flammable or combustible debris. This can avoid a small fire in the yard becoming a large fire that threatens your home and neighborhood. From the City of Yuma Road Report, work on the Avenue B reconstruction project will require a full closure at the intersection of Avenue B and 20th Street from 6 p.m. Friday, September 20th to the evening of Saturday, September 21st. Please plan ahead to avoid this area completely that day. For full and complete information about these and all items from the City of Yuma, please visit yumaaz.gov. This has been City News Yuma for late September 2024. Thank you for watching.